Monday, April 1st, 6:09 p.m. Today is the first day of the OWLS Readathon 2019. OWL stands for Ordinary Wizarding Level Exams. This readathon is inspired by the examinations that take place at Hogwarts. The creator is G, aka Book Roast on YouTube. I didn't participate last year, but this year I did not want to miss out. There are 12 prompts that you can do on their own for the readathon, and you could do however many as you want to for the month of April. If you want an added challenge, she created this amazing career guidebook. Being the Ravenclaw and the reader that I am, I chose librarian. It was a no-brainer for me because even in real life, I've wanted to be a librarian. Every career is different. It tells you what classes you need to pass. Let me go through all 12 real quick. Ancient runes, arithmancy, astronomy, care of magical creatures, charms, defense against the dark arts, divination, herbology, history of magic. My notes say muffled studies. I'm pretty sure that's supposed to be muggle studies. Potions and transfiguration. Librarians must be adventurous, brave, knowledgeable, and resourceful. They are required to pass ancient runes, arithmancy, defense against the dark arts, history of magic, and transfiguration. Basically, I highlighted those required classes, so those would take priority. But I wouldn't be a Ravenclaw if I hadn't set an extra challenge by saying, I'm gonna try and fulfill all 12 prompts. It is a month-long challenge. I think I can do it. First up, I'm going to go ahead and take my ancient runes exam. For this prompt, you need to read a retelling. So I'm going to read The Warrior Maiden by Melanie Dickerson. It is a Mulan-inspired story. I don't have the physical book, so I'm going to be listening to the audiobook on Scribd.
It's almost 8:40 a.m. Today's April 2nd, day 2. After I talked to you yesterday, I turned on my audiobook, fully expecting to get some good reading in. And during the first chapter, I kept falling asleep. So halfway through, I turned it off to take a quick nap. That was already a dumb idea because I believe it was around 7 that I laid down. I got back up at around somewhere between 9 and 10 and I was still in my work clothes. So I really wanted to get out of those, at least finish the chapter I was reading, and watch an episode of Game of Thrones. Next thing I know, I'm waking up again and it's 1 a.m. Still in my work clothes, didn't finish a chapter, didn't watch Game of Thrones. So here we are. It's early, which means I have a lot of time to get things done. It is now almost 10:30. I finished 5 chapters in my book while I was eating breakfast, and now the time has come. It's 3 minutes to midnight. I kind of set a goal like midday. I wanted to read at least 16 chapters in my book. And then in Game of Thrones, ideally, I wanted to get through like maybe 6 episodes. Here's what I actually accomplished. I got through 18 chapters in my book, and I am currently 19 minutes away from finishing episode 5 of Game of Thrones season 1. And while I was listening to my audiobook, I also got a blog post written, which I haven't done since January. I even got in a workout, did some yoga for my back pain, as well as some leg and arm exercises. It is 1 o'clock. I was up, what time did I get up? Like, was I up at 11 maybe? I did stay up and watch the 6th episode of Game of Thrones. I have accomplished something though. I finished my audiobook for The Warrior Maiden. Not my favorite Melanie Dickerson. I was really excited for a retelling of Mulan. There was a lot of great stuff involving her as a warrior. It's about a character named Mulan, except in order to keep the story within the same Hagenheim universe of this particular fairy tale retelling series, Mulan has been adopted by a family in Lithuania, but she's still Chinese, or in the story what they would call like Mongol or Mongolian, I believe is what they said. Her adopted father dies, and
they can't let the government know that because I'm not really sure what they would do with her family. I think like they would lose their home and a lot of what they own. So she disguises herself as a son and goes to fight in his place. The Duke of Hagenheim is obviously in Germany, but he sends his sons to fight because he's an ally with this army. The enemy is actually, I believe, German, but the Duke does not agree with the way that they handle war and the way they treat people. Mulan ends up falling in love with his son Wolfgang. Something about it didn't come together the way I wanted it to. In these fairy tale retellings, I know that insta-love is in a way always somewhat part of that formula. In some books it's worked. In this one, the romance just didn't work for me. And I think it had a lot to do with chemistry, but the book wasn't terrible. So that's why I gave it about 3 stars, because it's right down the middle. I'm probably gonna dedicate time to Game of Thrones right now, since I spent the last 2 hours finishing my book. It is 4:24 p.m. I actually just paused Game of Thrones because a fellow Ravenclaw, Gabrielle Rose, just tweeted that she is in the Ravenclaw Common Room and she's working on her History of Magic exam. So I thought I would join her along with some others. You can pick whatever exam you want to work on, but I think I might follow her lead and do History of Magic since I haven't picked my next book yet. I did have Mansfield Park in that slot for a book published at least 10 years ago, but I have really been wanting to read Frankenstein. I think I'm gonna go ahead and turn on Frankenstein.
You will rejoice to hear that no disaster has accompanied the commencement of an enterprise which you have regarded with such evil forebodings.
I worked on my History of Magic exam for a little bit, but honestly, I was having a really hard time concentrating. I was kind of falling asleep. I had to restart it so many times. So now I'm back to watching Game of Thrones. I just finished season 1, episode 9. And if you're a fan of the show, you know what happens. I actually turned on the camera as soon as my eyes dried, of course, but I did cry. Game of Thrones kind of lured us all into a false sense of security because the first death was Rhaegar. And I don't think any of us liked Rhaegar Targaryen. He was creepy and just an awful person all around. They let us off easy, and then in episode 9, Ned Stark. Leading up to episode 9, I don't think anyone had a first impression of Joffrey that was like, oh, this kid's cool, or like any positive first impression. No, you hate him immediately, but it's like a dislike. And then he tells Sansa that if her father pledges allegiance to the throne and to him as king, he could live. For the sake of his family and his daughter, Ned does so publicly, and Joffrey still has him beheaded on the spot. No warning. Obviously, I haven't watched every TV show ever made, but I'm pretty sure Joffrey is the worst of the worst, because this is just the tip of the iceberg. I have to put up with him until he finally dies. I feel like this time around is actually harder because I'm seeing all the foreshadowing that I didn't understand the first time around, and I'm just like, oh, I don't like it at all. I'm gonna continue with this. I do need to work out at some point, but hopefully later on I can get back to Frankenstein and give it a second chance. It's a couple minutes past 11. Another yoga session done. A little bit of legs and arms. Oh, I didn't really feel like working out, to be honest. Having some cramping, but I did. Still watching Game of Thrones. Haven't read any more today. I think I'm gonna take a short bath and listen to an audiobook. First update of the day, 5:45 p.m. I don't have much to report because today's been just gross and I've been in bed all day. I don't know if I'm still really pale, but my mom said I look super pale. I've been listening to Frankenstein all day and I've barely made a dent in it because I keep having to restart chapters because I get to the end and I have no idea what happened. I've actually restarted chapter 10 probably close to 10 times. Like, it's ridiculous. That's basically it. I haven't watched any Game of Thrones yet. There is something very cool coming at 9 p.m. During the BookTube games in February, the Jonas Brothers made their comeback. And tonight at 9 p.m., their new song Cool is debuting. We're down to the 1 minute countdown. 47, 46, 45, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
It's bingo night. They're gonna love you.
Take the Ferrari home.
I'm feeling so cool.
the top to the bottom, just cool. Every little thing that I do, damn it, I'm feeling so cool. Standing there with the red dress on, yeah, I kill a queen like
red dress. Nice.
Once again, another catchy song by the Jonas Brothers. I have to say that I called something weeks ago when they started sort of hinting at this. I was getting a Burning Up vibe from this style. I remember in the Burning Up video, they did, I think it was like Miami Vice. I think they did film this in Florida, and I got this vibe again, and it felt like a callback to Burning Up. And then in the song, they say red dress. This song feels special in that way because it's like a callback to Burning Up, which is such a hit back in the day. I don't know, it's kind of like an adult, like a newer version of that for all of us now that are grown up. I know it's spring, but I feel like this is going to be a summer anthem. Oh, that red dress part, that was really cool. Even the way Joe was dressed and like his mustache and everything, same with Burning Up. I really, really, really it. I don't even know what to say. It feels good to have him back, doesn't it? I know not everyone gets it, but I can truly say, like, this was my childhood. I was a Joe Bros fangirl. It is 5:40. I just got home from work, probably about 40 minutes ago, actually. I wish I had a better update for you, but I don't. I decided to keep going with Frankenstein, which may or may not be the stupidest thing I've ever done. Before work and on the way to work, I did listen to a few chapters and was doing fine, and then I hit this one chapter again, and I keep having to listen to it over and over again. My brain, it's like, I can go a few chapters and I know exactly what's happening. And I get to a particular chapter and I get to the end and I'm like, I have to re-listen. I don't know what happened. Scribd does have the physical book or ebook, so I don't know. Maybe I need to be switching between them. Maybe that'll be better. I'm gonna let my food settle, work out. I just washed my hair last night, but since I'm working out, I'm gonna have to take a shower again because we're going to a wedding tomorrow. And I think I'm gonna curl my hair. I didn't work out. I fell asleep, and right now I'm reading Frankenstein and eating some strawberries. So, yeah.
I swear this will look better tomorrow for the wedding. I just curled it. Actually, I used a waver, and then I didn't touch it. I just sprayed a ton of hairspray into it. So, right now, it looks not great, but I just want it to sit and really set, if that makes sense. And then tonight, I'm gonna try really hard not to sleep on it. I like sleeping on my stomach anyway, so hopefully that works in my favor. I also finished Frankenstein. Ooh, ooh. It took me way too many days, but I'm glad I stuck with it. I didn't love it, but I didn't hate it. I can't figure out if my problems have to do with my lingering book slump or even with the narrator. I feel like for this story, maybe I should have looked for a more dramatic reading of it. I think it's such an interesting story. Obviously, Frankenstein is everywhere, especially around Halloween time, but it's kind of fascinating, first of all, because we call him Frankenstein, but the monster doesn't actually have a name. Frankenstein is the doctor who created him. The monster in the book isn't actually the sort of like dumb monster that's become so popular in like pop culture. He's actually really smart. When he escapes from his creator, he adapts to his surroundings. He starts spying on humans and learning language. The only thing is his appearance. He's made of different body parts, like from different bodies. He has a couple of interactions with humans and he realizes that even though he can speak, his appearance is off-putting.
off-putting, and people see him as a monster, which enrages him and causes him to kill. That's an interesting part of it in and of itself, is that he didn't start out a monster, but because of human reaction to the way he looked on the outside, that caused him to hate himself and put that seed in his heart that created a monster from the inside out. I had problems getting through certain parts of the book, but I mean, there's some parts that you could really dissect and discuss for hours. I think now I'm gonna watch one episode of Game of Thrones and then go to bed, because I don't have to get up super early, but I do have to be up early enough that I can make this look presentable. Do I look better now? I'm gonna fix it. I have to fix it.
Blue didn't mean to fall asleep, but she did for another hour and 12 minutes. It wasn't her alarm that woke her this time either. It was a single thought shouted in her brain. Today is the day Gansey comes for his reading. Embroiled in the daily routine of getting ready for school, the conversation between Maura and Neve seemed more commonplace than it had before. But the journal was still as magical. Sitting on the edge of her bed, Blue touched one of the quotes. The king sleeps still under a mountain.
Okay, so it's 11:56. We're about to leave. I just filmed a quick clip of my outfit. Hopefully you can see it. The top's kind of a mix of autumn and fall, but I really like it. It's a large, so I'm wearing it like a tunic. And my hair turned out okay. I think so. Probably can't see the back. But I just like clipped a section back like that, and then I braided and clipped it right there. Yeah, that's my hair. Kind of nervous. I never wear lipstick out of the house. I've also been doing some fantastic reading. I'm listening to The Raven Boys. I'm already on chapter 11 and I'm really liking it so far. Obviously, I don't know how much reading's gonna get done because we have the wedding and reception. Probably my last update until the evening. So I will see you later. Just got home from the wedding. We actually left the reception after dinner. Haven't done any more reading, so I'll give you a better update later. So it's a couple minutes to 10 o'clock. I fell asleep. I think I got through like one more chapter of The Raven Boys. I think I'm gonna call it a night on reading. I'm just gonna get ready for bed and try and get through at least one or two episodes of Game of Thrones. I should probably warn you, Game of Thrones actually premieres in like a week. So I'm thinking that especially in the next week, in order to get through all seven seasons, I'm gonna have to like ramp up the episodes per day. I'm still gonna be reading, but I might be reading a little less. As long as I finish at least three books per week, I'm on track. One of my shortest books is Charlotte's Web. So I'm thinking that I can finish that whole book tomorrow, and then that'll bring me up to three books for week one. So that's kind of the plan in my head. Say goodbye because my hair has been de-waved and the makeup's gone. Time for Game of Thrones. It's like 9:20, 9:30, something like that. I was gonna sleep in more, but I gotta watch lots of Game of Thrones today. I also have to read at some point. I'm gonna go grab breakfast. Game of Thrones. I have to stop to listen to church around like noon, but then I'll get right back to it. I really want to get into season 3 today. I'm on season 2, episode 8. It is around 12:40. I just finished my lunch from Chipotle and listened to church. So back to Game of Thrones. I've already watched 2 episodes and I think I'm now on season 2, episode 10. Oh, last one actually. I'm at the part, spoiler alert, where Joffrey has decided to break his engagement from Sansa Stark. They're all thinking it's scandalous and it's gonna ruin her, and really she's happy. Maybe after this episode, or maybe I'll watch one more from season 3, and then do a little bit of reading. Moving on to season 3. We all know what happens in season 3. I don't know if I'll make it to episode 9 tonight or early tomorrow. Not looking forward to it. The first time I watched The Red Wedding gutted me. This time around, obviously I know what's gonna happen and I'm still scared. It is 9:40 p.m. I'm just checking in to let you know that I am reading. It is 10:30 p.m. Perfect timing. I finished Charlotte's Web 10 or 15 minutes ago. I'm putting in the last of my pages for the week. I ended up not filling in every day just because I mostly listen to audiobooks and it's kind of hard to determine page numbers. So I just filled in the days that I actually finished books. Day 3, I finished The Warrior Maiden, a total of 320 pages. Day 5, I finished Frankenstein, 288 pages. Day 7, today, I finished Charlotte's Web, 190 pages. My week 1 total is 798 pages and then 3 books total. To recap the exams I passed, The Warrior Maiden completed my Ancient Runes exam, a retelling. Frankenstein completed my History of Magic exam. It had to be a book that was published at least 10 years ago. Charlotte's Web completed my Transfiguration exam, which had to be either a book with sprayed edges, which I can show you now. This beautiful edition has gold sprayed edges. You could also read a book with a red cover. I had either, but I just went with Charlotte's Web because I've been wanting to reread it. It's important to note that the 3 exams I passed this week go towards my career. Lastly, I did want to show you the Magical Readathon Twitter page. G updated everyone that we have now, all of us involved, read over 500,000 pages, which is insane. For that amazing number of over 500,000 pages, she gave each house 50 points. There have been quizzes and different things to earn house points. Hufflepuff is in the lead right now. They have 370, Gryffindor has 230, Ravenclaw has 350, and then Slytherin has 210. That is going to be it for my week 1 updates and vlog. I am now going to watch Game of Thrones until I'm too tired to continue, and then go to bed, wake up early, and do it all over again, which you will see in my week 2 vlog. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit that red button down below to subscribe and become a member of my YouTube family. Also, click the bell to turn on your notifications. I will see you in my next video. Bye! For anyone that cares, I'm ending the week on Game of Thrones, season 3, episode 5.